Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Ayush Mittal and today we will learn about multi-stage centrifugal pump test and its order code is 23246610.1. So now let's move ahead to the components of multi-stage centrifugal pump test. So as we can see here we have our control unit. Now in this unit we can see three switches. This is our main switch, this is our pump 1 switch and this is our pump 2 switch. This is the LED indicator. This is toggle switch to measure the RPM of pump 1 and pump 2. Here we have our screen and as we can see here this is our centrifugal pump 1 and this is our centrifugal pump 2. This is single phase AC motor which measures the torque applied on the centrifugal pump 2 and this is our bearing to measure the pressure of the torque in motor. And as we can see here the outlet pipe is going from here and this is our measuring tank. In this measuring tank we can see this is our measuring scale which measures the amount of water through stopwatch and this is our sump tank through which water supply is provided through these valves when open. This is our pressure measurement gauge. This is our pressure measurement gauge and here we also have our pressure measurement gauge. As we can see here clearly, this is our centrifugal pump 1, this is our centrifugal pump 2 and this is our single phase AC motor. This motor is connected to pillow blocks and then it is connected to the bearing and after that it is connected to the spring measurement which measures the amount of torque applied at the centrifugal pump 2. Now, as we can see here, various valves are connected. Now, this valve is for supply of water in centrifugal pump 2 and this valve is for supply of water in centrifugal pump 1. This is to allow the supply in series and parallel and this valve is also for the same use and these two valves are basically for the supply of water in our outlet pipe. So now let's move ahead to the working of this unit. First of all, we will have to fill our sump tank with clean water up to 3/4 of its capacity. While filling the water, make sure that this valve is closed so that the water will not drain out while we fill the water. After filling the water, we will have to connect the switches here from the centrifugal pump 1 and centrifugal pump 2. We will have to connect both the switches to our control unit and from here our main power supply switch is connected and you can see here two proximity sensors are also coming out from here. These are further attached from both the centrifugal pump so that we can measure the RPM of both the pumps. Here we have our spring pulley which is connected to our single phase AC motor. This pulley is used to measure the torque provided from the centrifugal pump to the motor. Now we will on our both the pumps so that water can flow. Before switching on the pump, make sure that all the valves, these valves must be open or closed in such a manner that we can flow the water in series connection in parallel connection. As of now we have connected the valves such that this is our series connection. This valve is open so that the water can flow in this pump and through this pump the water will go up and this valve is closed so that water cannot pump directly to the outlet pipe and this valve is open so that water from the second pump will come to this pump, this pipe and from here it will go to our first pump and make sure to close this valve so that direct water cannot be supplied to our second pump and from the outlet of this pipe the water is then further goes in outlet pipe so that we will make sure that this valve is open so that outlet water will go through this pipe. Now we will turn on both the pumps. First of all we have to on our main supply switch. After that we will simultaneously on both the pumps so that our series connection of water flow is started. As you can see, both the pumps started flowing the water. Here we have, this is our acrylic sheet glass tube, which is used for detecting any kind of cavitation in our water flow. This will detect cavity if there are bubbles in this tube. Here, as we can see, both our pressure and vacuum gauges measuring the pressure and vacuum. As when you can see, when this needle is going in right direction, then positive pressure is maintained in this pipe, and when this needle goes in left direction, then negative pressure is maintained. Now we will have to take observations through these gauges and flow rate. So as we can see, here we have our manual for parallel setup and series setup. As we have series setup here, so here we can write our PS1 pressure, that will be the pressure in that gauge. And when we will measure the parallel setup, the PS1 pressure will be same as that in this pressure gauge, and PS2 will be the pressure in this gauge. After that, the PD1 pressure will be the pressure in. Now, if this PD1 pressure, both in parallel setup and in series setup, will be the pressure in this outlet pressure gauge connected here. After that, we have to measure the F, that is flow rate. For to measure the flow rate, we have to measure it from our measuring tank. Now to measure the flow rate, we will have to measure it through our measuring tank. Here we can see a measuring scale is connected. From here we will measure how many liters of water is stored in this measuring tank with respect to time. So we will also have to start a stopwatch while calculating the amount of water stored in this tank. So in this flow rate, we will have to fill liter per hour units. After that, we will have our rotations per minute of motor 1, centrifugal pump 1, and rotations per minute of our centrifugal pump 2. We will have to fill these also in both the series as well as parallel setup. So to calculate RPM of both the pumps, we will have to take these RPM from our control unit. So as we know, this is our toggle switch. So when we will shift it on 1, then the screen will show the RPM of centrifugal pump 1, and when we will shift it on 2, then it will show the RPM of our pump 2. So from this you can measure the RPM of both the pumps and can observe and fill it in observation table. After filling all the readings as discussed, we will have to do calculations according to the calculations mentioned in the manual, and this is how we can test the performance of centrifugal pumps. So that's all from my side for this apparatus. If you guys have any doubt regarding this apparatus, you can go to the website Tesla Global and you can also visit the manual. And if you like this video, please hit the like button and do subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to share it with your friends. Thank you for watching this video.